Here's an exercise I like to do to get you thinking about how your brain might adapt to a new number system. Imagine you live in a society that uses only the following numbers. This many is called ora. This many is sai. Then we have momo and latata. All larger numbers are made by combining these numbers together. Now, every job is important, but two really important jobs in this society are the village lookout and the village strategist. When an army approaches, the village lookout has to shout out to the strategist, communicating how many battalions in size the army is. The strategist then has to weigh up whether the army approaching is bigger or smaller than the village's own army. If it's bigger, then the town will need to evacuate. So first, imagine you're the strategist, and your army is this many battalions. The lookout shouts, "Momo, Momo!" Do you run away? How about if the lookout shouts, "Latata, Momo!" Take a note of your answers for later. Now you've had a go at deciphering numbers, how about building numbers? So imagine for a second that you're now the village lookout. How would you communicate the size of this many battalions using the society's number system? And then what about this many battalions? Write down your numbers using the society's words. Now, this is a completely made up system, so there would be no sense in which what you said is right or wrong, but I think it's interesting to look at how your brain intuitively interprets and builds numbers. Over at least 5 years of trialing this little exercise, the majority of students playing the role of village lookout would convey this many using either momo momo or latata sai, and the village strategist would always understand them. In other words, the natural intuition is to build new numbers by adding values together. Is this what you did? The thing is, all of us from the age of about 2 or 3 have learned to count and interpret numbers in a very different way. When we count in our number system, once we run out of symbols, we move to the next place value and write a 1, so that 1, 3 means 1 lot of 10 and 3 units. And so when we see the number 2 placed next to a 2, we don't add them together to make 4. We interpret this as 2 tens and 2 ones. In the first exercise, did you interpret momo momo to mean 2 plus 2? If these 4 number words were used the same way we use our 10 symbols, the progression should be sai, momo, latata, and then the next number would be sai ora, and then sai sai, sai momo, sai latata, then momo ora. So momo momo, if the imaginary society's number system were more like ours and used place value, would be 2 lots of 4 and 2 ones. And then did you interpret latata momo to mean 3 lots of 4 and 2 ones? Or did you add 3 and 2 together to make 5? When it comes to understanding our own place value system, as well as understanding that we have different special names for each place, and that each place when we move across to the left is worth 10 times more or 10 times less when we move to the right, and that these correspond with powers of 10, I think a really important thing to keep in mind is that our number system is not very intuitive. Even after decades of learning and thinking within a place value system, to the point that we take this kind of system for granted, even then, most of us would still lean towards interpreting momo momo as 4. So additive systems, systems where the total value of a number corresponds with adding all the symbols together, are much more intuitive. And if you're a child that's just starting to learn to count in our modern day system, it's hard. And we shouldn't be surprised at the difficulties and misconceptions that can persist well into primary school and even high school. Of course, while place value systems are not intuitive, they are very powerful. And our societies can certainly owe a lot of our advances in mathematics to the development of these kinds of numeration systems.